Good morning, students, and welcome to another online biology classroom of St. Michael's Academy. Today I am going to discuss the last part of body fluid and circulation. So let's start. So first I am starting with regulation of cardiac activity. The cardiac cycle is a normal activity of the human heart and is regulated automatically by the nodal tissues, sinoatrial node, that is SA node, and atrioventricular node, that is AV node. The variation in the cardiac cycle results in an increase or decrease in the cardiac output. See the first diagram. Here are regulation of cardiac activity has been shown in a tabular form. So regulation of cardiac activity has been divided into two parts, intrinsic regulation and extrinsic regulation. And extrinsic regulation again divided into two parts, neural regulation and hormonal regulation. Now in the second picture, you can see the neural regulation, neural word obviously related to brain. So, heart and brain related activities are called neural, and neural regulation means when our brain regulates our heart activities. You can see in the picture. Now, blood pressure. What is blood pressure? Blood pressure is lateral pressure exerted by the blood on the inner walls of the vessels while flowing through the vessels. Normal blood pressure numbers of less than 120 by 80 millimeter mercury are considered within the normal range. Common factors that can lead to high blood pressure include a diet high in salt, fat and or cholesterol, chronic conditions such as kidney and hormone problems, diabetes and high cholesterol, family history, especially if your parents or other close relatives have high blood pressure. So blood pressure is measured in units of millimeters of mercury or mmHg. The readings are always given in pairs, with the upper or systolic value first, followed by the lower or diastolic value. Diastolic blood pressure of 88 mercury. Now, cardiac output is the amount of blood and heart pumps in 1 minute, and it is dependent on the heart rate, contractility, preload and afterload. So, important things about blood pressure I have discussed here. You can see in the diagram how the blood pressure we used to measure, or doctor rather used to measure. Rest of the thing, please study from your book properly so that you can easily correlate with this video and your book. Disorders of circulatory system. There are some disorders of circulatory system. First one is hypertension. Hypertension is another name for high blood pressure. It can lead to severe health complications and increase the risk of heart disease, stroke, and sometimes death also. Blood pressure is the force that a person's blood exerts against the walls of their blood vessels. You can see in the first diagram I have shown the due to hypertension, how heart or circulation of heart is affected. And the second one is angina pectoris. Angina pectoris is the medial terms for chest pain or discomfort due to coronary heart disease. It occurs when the heart muscle doesn't get as much blood as it needs. This usually happens because one or more of the heart's arteries is narrowed or blocked, also called ischemia. So in the second one or second picture, I have shown the disorders of circulatory system due to angina pectoris. Coronary artery disease is the narrowing or blockage of the coronary arteries. This condition is usually caused by atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis is the buildup of cholesterol and fatty deposits called plaques inside the arteries. Diseases or conditions caused myocardial infarction. You can see in the first diagram, normal artery and narrowing of artery has been shown. The second one is heart failure, sometimes known as congestive heart failure, occurs when your heart muscle doesn't pump blood as well as it should. Certain conditions such as narrowed arteries in your heart or coronary artery disease or high blood pressure gradually leave your heart too weak or stiff to fill and pump efficiently. So in the second picture, heart failure has been shown with a normal heart picture. Causes of common cardiovascular diseases. First one is cardiovascular diseases due to dietary factors. Diet is an important risk factor in coronary heart disease. Food-related risk factors include obesity, high blood pressure, uncontrolled diabetes, and a diet high in saturated fats. A low saturated fat, high fiber, high plant food diet can substantially reduce the risk of developing heart disease. I have given a chart of the harmful diet plans which affects the blood pressure, starting from blood pressure to vascular adhesion. You can see it. This is a very interesting chart that I have given. Second one is cardiovascular diseases due to smoking. Smoking increases the formation of plaque in blood vessels. Coronary heart disease occurs when arteries that carry blood to the heart muscle are narrowed by plaque or blocked by clots. Chemicals in cigarette smoke cause the blood to thicken and form clots inside veins and arteries. So, major diseases caused by smoking, cardiovascular disease. You can see in the picture, I have given you the picture clearly. Cardiovascular disease causes poor circulation, angina or chest pains, heart attacks, stroke, etc. due to smoking. Number C, cardiovascular diseases due to stress. Studies suggest that the high levels of cortisol from long-term stress can increase blood cholesterol, triglycerides, blood sugar, and blood pressure. These are common risk factors for heart disease. This stress can also cause changes that promote the buildup of plaque deposits in the arteries. So, in the picture, it has been clearly shown due to anxiety how cardiovascular diseases or chances of rather cardiovascular diseases increases. Number D, cardiovascular diseases due to diabetes mellitus. Diabetes is a prime risk factor for cardiovascular disease, that is CVD. Vascular disorders include retinopathy and nephropathy. Peripheral vascular disease or PVD, stroke, and coronary artery disease or CAD, CAD. Diabetes also affects the heart muscles, causing both systolic and diastolic heart failure. And the last one, but not the least, is cardiovascular diseases due to alcoholism. Alcoholic cardiomyopathy is a form of heart disease caused by alcohol abuse. Long-term alcohol abuse weakens and thins the heart muscle, affecting its ability to pump blood. When your heart can't pump blood efficiently, the lack of blood flow disrupts all your body's major functions. Except this cardiovascular disease, actually alcohol is very harmful to our body, for brain, for excretory system, rather kidney, heart and pulmonary disease and liver also. So it has been only shown in the picture. For any doubts or queries, please email me at sudeshna1.sma@outlook.com. We also welcome your responses by way of your views and feedback on PPTs or videos at feedback.stmichaelsacademy@gmail.com. Thank you, students, and have a nice day. Hope all of you are well.